In today's lecture, we will be covering first order differential equations of the first degree. We are mostly concerned about identifying various forms of these differential equations and devising quick and efficient ways to obtain the solution. As you may already know, first order differential equations do not all necessarily have an easily obtainable solution. Hence, while we conform to the scope of an undergraduate mathematics course, we will attempt to identify and solve these special forms. So the prerequisites to solve any of these problems which I am going to give today, and in general to understand what the lecture is about, you would need to have a basic knowledge of differentiation and integration, which means you would have to know how to differentiate almost any function, as well as to use certain integration techniques to solve some integrals. In this course, in this lecture, I will not be solving any of the integrals. It will be left to the viewer, and it is highly recommended that you solve these integrals later on. The lecture outcomes are, mainly we will attempt to identify the forms of differential equations. As you know that the first order differential equations cannot all be solved. So we will be always given certain special forms of differential equations, be it in an exam situation or even in general in your engineering course. So these special forms of differential equations are variable separable form, or else we have the reducible to variable separable form. I will show how these two are the same thing with just a difference in how you approach them. Then we also have homogeneous form and reducible to homogeneous form. Then we have exact differential equations and reducible to exact differential equations. Then there are some special forms which I will look into in the later slides. These special forms are mostly formulae which have to be committed to memory, or else certain special techniques where you can use them to solve problems quicker and better. Now we will look into variable separable form, but before I look into that, let me first define what a first order, first degree linear differential equation is. If we look at this differential equation mdx plus mdy equal to 0, where m is a function of x and y and n is a function of x and y, then this is the general form of any first order, first degree differential equation and is also the most simplest form. But we cannot solve this in general, hence we have certain special forms which we demonstrate. One of them is the variable separable form. If I put in a constraint on m and n such that m is a function of y and n is a function of x, so this is not the general form anymore, this is a special form where m is only a function of y and n is only a function of x. Then if we rewrite this, my dx plus nx dy is equal to 0, then we can take this to the other side, so we get my dx is equal to minus nx dy. Then we can simply take this to the left hand side and take this to the right hand side, then we get as so. Then, as you can see, since this is just a function of x and this is a function of y, we can just integrate both the sides and our solution is found. You have to integrate this function, then you have to integrate this, you get an answer, and then Bob's your uncle. So, as you can see, this is a very simple form, which is the variable separable form here. So, in order to demonstrate this better, let me tackle a problem. Dy by dx is equal to e to the power 3x minus 2y plus x square e to the power minus 2y. So in this function is not quite similar to what we showed earlier, mdx plus ndy equal to 0, but I will demonstrate how these two are exactly the same. First, we make an observation that this e to the power minus 2y is actually common to both the terms here, and we can easily remove it. So this is what we get. So here e to the power minus 2y is a function of y alone, and e to the power 3x plus x square is a function of x alone. So we can write it as the form f of y into g of x. easily f of y, as we observe, f of y can be taken to the left hand side and dx can be taken to the right hand side. So this is just another form of this mdx plus ndy equal to 0, just demonstrated in a different form, but essentially they are the same. So if we do that, we get integral e to the power 2y dy is equal to integral e to the power 3x plus x square dx. And this I leave to you, the viewer, to solve this integral and to obtain the final solution. I will leave a few seconds for this integral to remain on the screen. Alright. So now that we have tackled variable separable form, let us now look into the next type, which is reducible to variable separable form. So it is not always that a differential equation can be so easily solved like I showed here. Sometimes there might be some complication, or you may not easily be able to identify the variable separation. In which case, we can look into it as a reducible to variable separable form. So if we have the function, we have the differential equation mdx plus ndy equal to 0, and somehow or somewhere we make a substitution theta x comma y equal to t, such that this becomes of variable separable form, then we define that function, that differential equation, to be reducible to variable separable form, and this theta x comma y to be a substitution for it. So this can only be demonstrated by a problem. Let's tackle a problem to solve this. Dy by dx equal to 4x plus y plus 1 the whole square. So if we apply a framework which I will explain in later slides, we can see that this can neither be solved using homogeneous method, because dividing over will not lead to anything. You can see it is not variable separable on its own, nor is it any of the other forms, exact or linear or Bernoulli or anything. So we see that this could probably be a reducible to separable, variable separable form, and the only thing that catches our eye here is the easy access of y, 4x plus y plus 1, in that there is y here. So if we can take this to be some other term, as I showed here, theta x comma y equal to t, this theta x comma y is 4x plus y plus 1. If we take 4x plus y plus 1 is equal to t, and if we differentiate both sides with respect to x, then it's very simply this. So here we can easily see how this dy by dx is completely isolated, and all you have is another dt by dx minus 4. So we have essentially reduced this into single variable. So dy by dx is equal to dt by dx minus 4, which we can just replace here. Dt by dx minus 4 is equal to, and 4x plus y plus 1 is t, so t square. So t square plus 4. And then you just bring this to the other side and integrate both sides. You have this integral here, dt is equal to x plus c. Integral dx is x. This integral, I again leave to the viewer. It's a very simple application of a formula and you can solve it. So now we will approach another variable separable form just to properly cement your thinking. Let's look at this problem here, dy. This lecture will be mostly problem based, as identifying the forms of differential equations is very important. So over here, there is no way that you can approach this. It's quite easy to see. Let's say that you divided by x. Maybe you thought it was a homogeneous form, but the problem is it's not. The dividing by x will affect this one. Similarly, there is no other form. You cannot approach this using exact or anything else. So it's very simple to observe that this is just another variable separable form itself. Why? Because if you divide both sides by x, y, then what do you get? This y and this y would cancel, so you get root 1 minus x square by x dy plus for this term, and then over here the x would cancel instead, you get root 1 minus y square over y dx is equal to 0. So this is quite clearly in the form I had mentioned in the first slide itself. I said that m must be a function of y, which it is, and n must be a function of x, which it is. This is m and this is n. So bring this to the other side, switch the sides and solve the integral, and very clearly we get the integral here. We have to solve minus, we take this other side, that becomes minus of that, then we take it to that side, so it becomes minus y by root 1 minus y square. It becomes minus y by root 1 minus y square. Integral dy is equal to x by root 1 minus x square. Integral. And again, this integral is left to the viewer to solve. It's a very simple application of formula. All you have to do is to make substitution of y square. The next type which we will look into is what we call of the homogeneous form. So the homogeneous form, let's again write the general form here. So the homogeneous form says that if this m, which is some function of x comma y, and n, which is another function of x comma y, if this m and this n can be written as some function of v, where v is either y by x or x by y, it can be both. If v is either y by x or x by y, and this m and n both can be written in that function form, then we call it a homogeneous equation. So how do we approach, say for example, we have let's say we have y by x plus y by x squared into dx plus y by x dy equal to 0. Here clearly we can see m is y, the first term is some function of y by x, and the second term is also a function of y by x. So both the terms together added is a function of y by x, and similarly for n. So we can write it as a function of y by x, which is here in this case v plus we call v y by x as v. So v plus v square dx is plus v dy equal to 0, whatever. And then we know that v is equal to y by x, vx is equal to y. Differentiating both sides, we get this to be just dy by dx. Using the product rule here, we get v plus v dx by dx, which is 1, plus dv by dx into x is equal to dy by dx. Now all we have to do is to write this in that dy by dx form, which is quite simple, and then replace it by this. So I will demonstrate this method using a problem directly instead of doing it in general. So here is the problem. X squared minus y squared dx is equal to 2xy dy. So let's write it in dy by dx form. Dy by dx is equal to, what is this, x squared minus y squared by 2xy. If we split this 2xy for both the terms, we obtain, let's just take 1 by 2 out, we get, what do we get, x by y minus y by x. So here clearly, since v is equal to y by x, then obviously 1 by v is equal to x by y. So this is in a function form, as I demonstrated, it's a function form of f of v. F of v is equal to 1 by v minus v. So write it in that form. So you get 1 by 2, 1 by v minus v. And v is equal to y by x, so as vx is equal to y, dv by dx into x plus v is equal to dy by dx. Replace that here. What do we obtain? Dv by dx into x plus v is equal to this. I will preserve this equation. I will erase the ink of other slides, of other part. This is the important equation here. So we can take this v to the other side. So we get dv by dx into x is equal to half of so we write it as we let's write it as 1 minus v square over 2v minus v. Then we can multiply this, so we get 1 minus 3v square over 2v. So this is the equation we get here. Dv by dx into x is equal to 1 minus 3v square over 2v. Now it's quite simple that we can see that it is clearly in variable separable form. So the final integral 2v by 1 minus 3v square dv is equal to log x plus c, because as we know, integral of 1 by x is equal to log x. Now this integral again is left to the viewer. Solve this integral and you obtain the solution. So we dealt with homogeneous equations. The next type form which we look into is a more interesting form of homogeneous equations, known as the reducible to homogeneous form. So in the reducible to homogeneous form, we look a form like this. Is equal to dy by dx. So this is always the form you will observe a reducible to homogeneous differential equation to be in. So when we are attempting to identify the form for reducible to homogeneous, you can clearly observe that if you brought this to the right hand side, this denominator to the right hand side and dx to the left hand side, and then you brought everything to the left hand side, you would get it in mdx plus mdy is equal to 0. So sometimes it is possible that this mdx and mdy are exact, and if they are not exact, then you immediately infer that they are reducible to homogeneous. Again, once we get to the later slides, I will show how it is how to differentiate between homogeneous or exact or variable separable and so on. So here there are two types, a1, this a1 by a2, and this is b1 by b2. This not equal to b1 by b2. Yeah, so if a1 is 2, a2 is say 3, b1 is 4 and b2 is 6, so that time we consider the smaller part, which is 2 and 4. So we take 2x plus 4y to be some t. So when we do that, what do we get? We get 2 plus 4 dy by dx is equal to dt by dx. Then what do we get? We get dt by dx minus 2 by 4 is equal to dy by dx, which we replace here. And then what we get? T plus C1 by sum, in this case it is 2T plus C2 is equal to dt by dx minus 2 by 4. 4 can be taken to the other side, 4 into this whole thing, then 2 can be taken here, and very clearly we can see it is a variable separable form. So let's solve a problem to properly demonstrate this. Let's look into this form, 3y plus 2x plus 4 into dx minus 4x plus 6y plus 5dy equal to 0. We take this to the right hand side, so we get 3y plus 2x plus 4 into dx is equal to 4x plus 6y plus 5dy. Then dy by dx is equal to 3y plus 2x plus 4 divided by 4x plus 6y plus 5, which can very easily be written as 3y plus 2x plus 4 divided by 2 into 2x plus 3y plus 5. So let's make the substitution 2x plus 3y equal to t. Then 2 plus 3y prime, which is dy by dx short form, is equal to t prime. Then t prime minus 2 by 3 is equal to y prime, which we replace over here. So this is t prime minus 2 over 3 is equal to we already made the substitution. So this is t plus 4, this here and here, here, and this goes where? Here. T plus 4 by 2t plus 5. Now bring this to other side. So t prime minus 2 is equal to 3t plus 12 divided by 2t plus 5. If you take this 2 to the other hand, you get here, and then if you take the LCM, then you get 4t plus 10 whole. This is the whole thing, 2t plus 5. If you add them, 7t plus 22 divided by 2t plus 5. So I will erase this line. So in the finally we get dt by dx is equal to 7t plus 22 by 2t plus 5. Now what to do? Now dx we take to the other side, and that it's variable separable form. So integral 2t plus 5 by 7t plus 22 is equal to x plus c. This integral I leave to you to solve. You can note down the integral and solve it as an exercise. It is a pretty interesting integral to solve. The next form of differential equation which we will look at is the exact form of differential equation. The exact form or the exact differential equation, let's write the general form first, m dx plus n dy equal to 0, where m is a function of x, y and n is a function of x, y. Before we look into exact form, let's just have a brief demo of what is partial derivative. So let's define a function 6x plus 3y square, and we want to find the partial derivative of this function with respect to say x. So we are finding using this do symbol here. It's not d, it's do. It's a curly d. Now derivative of this with respect to x is just simply 6. Now this with respect to x, what we do is all y terms, anything which has y, is considered a constant when you are finding the partial derivative. So 3y square is considered a constant, and we all know it is going to be 0. So the final answer here is 0. So now we have partial derivatives out of the way. Let's look at what is the exact form. Let's say m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Then if the partial derivative of m with respect to y is equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x, then it is a exact form of differential equation. So what is the modus operandi to solve these type of problems, say reducible to exact or exact? Simple. All you do is first you find the partial derivative of m with respect to y, then you find the partial derivative of n with respect to x. Now if you check, if they are equal, then it is exact. If they are not equal, then there is some special form which we can consider, or it is reducible to exact, that I will look into later slides. But now let's assume that they were equal. So if they are equal, then this is a exact form of differential equation. So how to solve exact differential equation? We make use of this integral which is already derived for us. M dx plus integral n dy is equal to c. But what do we do? In this term, we say that all the terms of y are constant terms. So y terms are constant. Y constant. So where in m, whatever terms are y, they are constant. In n, all the terms which are not y, which are not y terms, they are ignored. So only y terms are considered in the integral. All x terms are ignored. Any term which has x or a power of x or anything with x is ignored in the integral. So y terms only here, no x terms. So now I will demonstrate how to do this by a problem itself. Let's look at the problem. Let's see the problem here. Y square into e to the power xy square plus 4x cube into dx is plus 2xy e to the power xy square minus 3y square dy is equal to 0. So m, which is this function, this is m and this is n. So dm by dy is equal to, we use product rule here, y 2y e to the power xy square plus y square by into 2 by y e to the power xy square, that thing is 0 there. Then this is dn by dx, where all the x terms are in dn by dx, the y terms are constant, so that 2y, so 2y e to the power xy square, we use product rule, so this x becomes 1 plus, now this stays constant, 2xy into x here, this is an x here, 2xy into what is this, e to the power xy square, so y term is constant, so it's just staying as e to the power xy square. So just a minute, so if y's term is constant, okay, so here we can see this whole thing in the end becomes 2xy e to the power xy square. So we see these two are equal, so their subtraction is going to be 0, so they are exact equation. So now if they are exact equation, we can solve using this integral m dx plus integral n dy. So here this is very easy to solve. Integral 4x cube will not be considered, we consider only the so this y square term will be considered constant, and only this e power xy square will be integrated with this considered as constant. Similarly, this 4x cube will be considered with y, you integrate, and n you ignore all of the x terms. So this term is completely ignored and you get only this integral to solve. So this solution of solving this integral is left to the viewer. You can solve the integral and you can obtain the solution very easily. So that was exact differential equation. Exact differential equation is a pretty simple form, but the difficulty arises when these two are not equal. Then we have a special method which I will demonstrate in the next slide. Reducible to exact. So let's say that these two were not equal. Then when we find the difference, let's say we figured out the difference, and this difference is some g of x comma y. Okay, so there are two conditions. Condition number one, if you take that difference, this difference which is g of x comma y, and if you divided that by n, okay, and you get some new function, and that function is only a function of x. So listen close, we take that difference d of m, dou of m divided by dou of y minus dou of n divided by dou of x, dou of n with respect to x is equal to some function g of x comma y, and we divide it by n. If this function, if the function obtained is only a function of x, then we define something called an integrating factor, and this integrating factor is equal to e to the power f of x dx. We define this integrating factor as e to the power f of x dx. Condition number two, if the negative of this means if you subtract dn of dx minus dou m over dou y, you get the negative of this, right? If this divided by m, instead of n it is m, is equal to some, say h of y, means it is only a function of y. If you take this function, which is the difference of between these two, get the minus of that, which means dn of dou n over dou x minus dou m over dou y, and if you divide it over m in the m dx plus n dy equal to 0, the second condition, you divide it by m, and if you obtain the function which is only a function of y, then the integrating factor is equal to, this is dx here, is equal to e to the power integral h of y dy. This is the integrating factor. So now we know what is the integrating factor. Now what we do to solve the problem? So for that, let me define what integrating factor actually is. I have told the formula now. Now let me explain what I mean by integrating factor itself. So when we look at an inexact equation, we see mdx plus ndy is equal to 0, and we know that dm by dy is not equal to dn by dx. So the trick is to multiply this and to multiply this differential equation by something, by some function. Let's call that function mu. We multiply that function by some mu such that in the end the function becomes an exact differential equation. So you multiplied this function by mu so that the function becomes exact differential equation, and this mu is the integrating factor. Mu is equal to if. This mu, which you multiply with this equation to get an exact equation, is called the integrating factor. So I showed how to find the integrating factor. It can be either e to the powers that g of x, like I showed last time, or it can be e to the power f of y dy also, depending on the formula. So it's an application of the formula which we use. After you get the integrating factor, you multiply the integrating factor with the original equation which you have. Then you get a new equation. Let's call that equation m1x plus m1 dx plus n1 dy is equal to 0. Now this equation is going to be an exact equation. You multiplied the integrating factor with the original equation. You got a new equation. That equation is an exact equation. And you solve the exact equation using the integral which is given. So to understand this better, it's always easy to understand these things with a problem. The problem is this: xy squared minus e to the power 1 by x cube dx minus x square y dy is equal to 0. Now let's first test dm by dy is equal to, this is just y square minus, this goes away, this is a constant term. Now dn by dx is equal to minus x square y minus 2xy. Okay, so dm by dy minus dn by dx is y square plus 2xy. Now y square plus 2xy is, I mean, these are not equal, right? Obviously these are not equal. So we find the difference. This is equal to the difference between them. So d, let me write it here just for reference. dn by dx is equal to y square plus 2xy. First, now let's test. Let's divide it by n. You know, if we divide this by n, y square plus 2xy divided by minus x square y, what do we get? We get y. This y would cancel. Y square. This is not y square. This is not y square. This is 2xy. This is 2xy. And this is minus 2xy. So the final result is minus is 4xy. This is 2xy because differential with respect to y. Y square is equal to, and this is xy, and this is not this is out of the consideration. Yes, so that was an error there. Dm by dy minus dn by dx is equal to 4xy as we obtained. So this is 4xy. 4xy divided by minus x square y is equal to minus 4 by x. As you can see, it is a function of only x. So because it is a function of only x, the integrating factor is equal to e to the power integral minus 4 by x dx, which we can rewrite as minus 4x itself. Why? Because this is e to the power minus 4 log x, which can be written as x to the power 1 by 4. I think, yeah. this can be written as x to the power 1 by 4. C term is not considered. So integrating factor is x to the power 1 by 4. So what do you do now? You multiply x to the power 1 by 4 into that thing over there. It is 1 by 4. Yeah. You multiply x to the power 1 by 4 into this original function. You obtain some new function. Then you use the exact method to solve that function. And you obtain a solution. So this I leave to you to solve, as it is quite a lengthy solution. We can do it easily. So now we have dealt with most of the general forms. We have dealt with variable separable form. We have dealt with homogeneous form. We have dealt with exact and reducible to exact form. And along with that, we have dealt with variable separables, reducible and reducible to homogeneous. So now we have some special forms which it is advisable to know these forms in order to solve any problem which is given to you. One of them is called the Leibniz linear form. Leibniz linear form. Let's look at it in the next slide. Reducible to exact is done. Leibniz linear and Bernoulli form. First, let's look at Leibniz linear. What is Leibniz linear? If any function can be written of the form dy by dx plus py equal to q, where p and q are functions of x alone, then this is called Leibniz linear. And Leibniz linear has a very simple solution. Y into e to the power integral p dx is equal to integral of q into integral p dx dx. So this is the solution to Leibniz linear, and it is advisable to remember this formula. I leave it on the screen for a few seconds. It's very simple formula. All you have to do is to identify the form and apply the formula. Okay. So we will solve a problem quickly using this formula. E to the power minus 2 root x by root x minus y by root x dx by dy is equal to 1. So dy by dx plus y by root x is equal to e to the power minus 2 root x by root by root x. Therefore, p is equal to 1 by root x and q is equal to e to the power minus 2 root x by root x. Therefore, y into integral y into e to the power p means 1 by root x dx is equal to integral e to the power minus 2 root x by root x into this part. So let's call that u, some mu or something, dx. So solve this integral and you have the answer. I leave this integral to you to solve. The next type is what we call Bernoulli equation. So Bernoulli equation is quite similar to Leibniz linear, except it is has a small difference. This is the form. Once again, p and q are functions of x. So we make the substitution. This substitution y power 1 minus n is equal to z. So let's differentiate with both sides. We get 1 minus n dy by d y to the power 1 minus n minus 1. So that's going to be minus n dy by dx is equal to dz by dx. So if you take everything to the right hand side except for dy by dx, dz by dx into y to the power n divided by 1 minus n is equal to dy by dx, isn't it? Yeah. So this we replace in this here. What do we get? Dz by dx into y to the power n by 1 minus n plus py is equal to qy to the power n. I will erase this part now. So we get this new thing here, and we know y to the power 1 minus n is equal to z. Now let's divide this both sides by y to the power n. What do we get? Dz by dx into 1 by 1 minus n, y cancels out there, so this goes. And here we get p y to the power 1 minus n, as you can see, is equal to q. But we know y to the power 1 minus n is z. So p dz by dx into 1 by 1 minus n plus pz is equal to q. And very clearly, if you multiply both sides by 1 minus n, you get, let me erase this, dz by dx plus p into 1 minus n z is equal to q into 1 minus n. And this is Leibniz linear, clearly. Leibniz linear in a different variable. Okay, so now that is clear. Let's solve a problem to further cement it. The solution, the problem is here. Xy into 1 plus xy square dy by dx is equal to 1. Let's we see dx by dy is equal to xy plus x square y cube. So if you consider this function to be with respect of x instead of y, we considered this to be dx by dy, we solved it with respect to x, then you can see that this is a Bernoulli equation in x term. Why? Because it is of the form we have now p of y and q of y, and here p of y is equal to y and q of y is equal to y cube. We have p of y and q of y here. Yeah, is equal to y cube. P of y is equal to y. Q of y is equal to y cube minus y here. Should be minus y. If you take this to other side, you get that. So, and n is equal to 2. So 1 minus n is equal to 1 minus 2, which is minus 1. So our substitution is z equal to 1 by x. Let's make this substitution. Z equal to 1 by x, x is equal to 1 by z. So we have 1 by z, z is equal to 1 by x. So dz by dy is equal to x to the power minus 1, that comes minus 1 by x square dx by dy. So dx by dy is equal to minus x square dz by dy. So replace that, replace this here. What do we get? I will erase this portion. If we replace this here, we get minus x square dz by dy is equal to xy plus x square y cube. If you divide both sides by the x square, dz by dy is equal to y by x plus y cube. But we know that 1 by x is that, so we get yz plus y cube. So dz by dy is equal to yz plus y cube, which is in Leibniz linear form. Let me preserve this equation. I'll erase this portion here. I'll erase this also. Okay. So we have dz by dy equal to yz plus y cube, which is Leibniz linear. So here p is equal to minus y, q is equal to y cube. So e to the power integral minus y dy is equal to if. So what we have, z into e to the power minus y dy is equal to integral y cube e to the power minus e to the power integral minus y dy dy. And this is the solution. And z itself is equal to 1 by x. So this is our final solution to the equation. This can be solved using integration techniques. I leave that to the viewer to solve. So we have completed Leibniz linear and Bernoulli equations, which leaves us only to some special forms which are remaining now. One important form is of this type. Special form. We have this form here, f of 1 xy into y dx plus f of 2 xy x dy is equal to 0. So what is this form trying to tell us? It's trying to tell us that there are two functions, and if both of these functions, the first function is multiplied by y and then dx, the second function is multiplied by x then dy, and the constraint is that both of these functions must be function containing only x, y. Like it must be a function with x, y only. There cannot be x, only x or only y or anything else. It must contain only x, y. So I will directly write that the integrating factor for this form is 1 by mx minus ny. M is what? This is m. N is what? This is n. So it is the same form. Mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. M is this thing here and n is this here. And you put that here. M into x minus n into y. That's the integrating factor. After you find the integrating factor, multiply the integrating factor with this equation. Then you get an exact equation and solve the exact equation using the exact formula. So I will just show a problem where I find the integrating factor. Then finding that exact equation is left to the reader. So here clearly we can see f of 1xy is equal to 1 plus xy, f of 2xy is equal to 1 minus xy. So integrating factor is equal to 1 by this whole thing, which is 1 plus xy into y into x minus 1 minus xy into x into y, which is equal to 1 by, let's remove xy. So we have 1 plus xy minus 1 plus xy, which gives us 1 by 2xy squared, whole squared. So this is the integrating factor. So we found the integrating factor, multiply the integrating factor with the original equation and then solve using the integral for exact differential equation. This I leave to the reader. So we have covered most of these special forms. We have covered exact form, we have covered homogeneous, variable, separable and other forms. Then there are some forms which are dependent on formulae, which are not necessary to delve into at this time, but maybe as a corollary lecture I will be delving into these formulae. You can refer the book B.S. Grewal for certain formulae which need to be committed to memory, as well as to solve some problems, interesting problems, using the concepts which I have mentioned here. I have only looked into a very few set of problems. We can always look into more problems which will have much more thinking involved, where you need to reduce it using a substitution or using inspection or things like that in order to get to the form which you want. Now I will be talking about the differential equation framework by which we can identify various forms of differential equation in an exam setting. Obviously, in an exam setting, they will not tell you whether this is an exact differential equation or whether it is reducible to exact or variable separable or homogeneous and so on. So we need to be able to efficiently and quickly find a way to identify the equation. So how is that done? Let's first look at So what is the framework? What is the algorithm? First you look at the equation mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. You see if it is in one of the forms I mentioned, whether m, you see whether m is a function of only y and n is only a function of x, then you know it is in variable separable. If not, then you check whether it is in y by x form or x by y form, then you know that it is in homogeneous form. Otherwise, you check whether it is reducible to homogeneous form. Now, for example, if you have an equation where you think it is reducible to homogeneous, say 6x plus 2y plus 1 into dx plus 3x plus y plus 2 into dy is equal to 0. You look at this equation and you think whether it is homogeneous or not. So first what you do is you check whether it is exact or not. If it is exact, then you can solve it using exact method much easier than solving it using reducible to homogeneous method. If it is not exact, then you use reducible to homogeneous method. So this is the differential framework I am trying to guide you to, where you quickly try to identify what form it is, because once you identify the form, it is very simple to solve the problem. So with that, we are going to end our lecture, but we have a special part for the viewer to look into. Intentionally, I skipped the second part of reducible to homogeneous equations. I intentionally skipped this because I would like it to be an exercise to the viewer to solve this part of reducible to homogeneous. The part where the ratio of the two of the constants in the equation are not equal. So let's take a look at an example. Dy by dx is equal to y plus x minus 2 divided by y minus x minus 4, where these terms here, 1 is not equal to minus 1. These two are not equal. If you divide this by this and this by this, the coefficients, you would get them to be not equal. So when it is not equal, there is a different method to solve and get it to homogeneous form, and I will not be doing it in this lecture. Instead, I would like for the viewer to go to one or more reference books and figure out this method on their own. By doing so, you will be able to understand reducible to homogeneous equations much better and also try to solve a few problems. The book which I would recommend to learn reducible to homogeneous is B.S. Grewal by Khanna Publishers. This book I recommend to learn this final portion, which this lecture will not be covering, intentionally for the students' benefit to learn something on their own. With that, I end this lecture. See you next time.